Hello everyone, my name is Arun Kumar and I am again in front of you with my next video, that is I am from XYZ field, can I become a data engineer? Okay, this is a very common question that comes in the mind of students. Okay, and before proceeding in this video, let me tell you, this video is going to give you a lot of positivity if you are really trying to move into this data engineering field from any other field you are already working in. Okay, so let me proceed with this video. That students generally ask come and ask, Arun, can I I'm working in non-IT field. Okay, and what are those non-IT field? They say that, Arun, I'm working in banking field. Arun, I'm working in BPO. Arun, I'm working in mechanical engineering. Arun, I'm working in electrical engineering field. Arun, I'm working in civil engineering, etc. There are many such kind of non-IT domains in which students are working, and they want to move in this data engineering field because there might be many reasons, and one of the foremost very obvious reason is the opportunity, that the good opportunity that is this data engineering is offering apart from any other job profiles. Okay, so there might be many reasons for that movement, that people want to move from these fields to data engineering. Okay, if we talk about some other fields, like in which people are already working in the IT industry, okay, like some people are working in the support project, some people are working as SQL developers, okay, some people are working as .NET developers, okay, some people are working as BI developer, business intelligence developers, okay, and they also want to move to this data engineering field. Okay, similarly, let me write it here. Similarly, there are many fields, etc. Okay, many fields from where students wants to move to this data engineering field due to the good opportunity that this data engineering is giving to people, to students. Okay, now they ask that, I'm working in these fields. Okay, I listed down few of the fields. Can I move into data engineering? Okay, so let me tell you a very clear cut answer for this, that of course yes, this is possible. I have personally seen people moving from these domains to these domains. Okay, if I tell you a story, I have seen people having BA degree becoming an architect. Okay, having BA degree becoming a data engineering architect. Okay, in a very very leading organization. Okay, in a very leading organization, and this BA degree, okay, he was working in company, and I mean after BA degree he was working in company, and while working he did his distance MBA program. Okay, he did distance MBA, and he is right now working as architect in a leading IT company in India. Okay, so what other example can I give? If a person having BA degree can become architect, then why can't you become a data engineer? Okay, why can't you from all these domain can become data engineer? Okay, if I myself talk about, I studied in college this electrical engineering, and from there I moved into this IT industry. So just I want to tell you that these domains, in whatever domain you are working or in whatever domain you have degree, it really doesn't matter. Okay, it really doesn't matter, and you can switch from any domain to data engineering. It's just some of the company criteria that decides whether you can like suppose TCS is hiring, so they can say that I need MCA people or BTech people, okay, in their company. Okay, every company has different kinds of criteria, so just you have to look for the companies who is not looking for a specific degree. Many companies are there in the market who doesn't look for a specific degree. Okay, So you can easily move into this data engineering field from any other field. Okay, the only thing that you need is your hard work and discipline. Okay, the hard work, of course, many candidates are not confident enough, many students are not confident enough that they can move to this data engineering field or not. Okay, as they are not working in this data engineering or they are not from CSIT background. Okay, but let me tell you, with hard work and discipline, okay, if you have these two things with you, okay, you will surely reach to this profile where you want to go. Okay, and believe me, this is one of the best profile in the market, one of the best profile in the market that can give you one of the best salary that is available in this IT industry in the market. Okay. Yes, so this was all the things that I wanted to discuss. Okay, so now the next question that comes up is, Arun, so I am from these domains, so how can I move to data engineering field? Okay, before going into that, let me discuss some of the points. Those who are already working in the SQL developer role, okay, or in this BI developers role, okay, for them the task becomes much easier. Okay, for them the task becomes much easier as they are already handling data. Okay, as they are already handling or processing data. Okay, so people who are working in these two profiles, as SQL developer or in BI developer like Power BI, Tableau, QlickSense, okay, in all those tools and technologies, whoever is working, for them the task becomes easier as they are already handling the data, right? They are already handling the data. Okay, but if it is easy for them, it's not like that it is not easy for others. Okay, if they are able to become, they are able to learn data engineering in suppose 4 months, okay, although there is no end of perfection, it's not I am writing 4 months, so in 4 months you will learn everything. Okay, it's a continuous process. With experience you will gain more and more expertise. Okay, I'm just taking a figure, like suppose they are able to learn in 3 months. Okay, so what maximum can happen? Maximum that can happen is people from any other field will be learning this data engineering in 5 months. Okay, this is the maximum thing that can happen. But it's not like that if they are already working in SQL developer or as a BI developer, that's why they are taking 3 months of time, and that's why only they will be able to switch into data engineering. No, it's not the case actually. It's just that those who are not working in SQL as SQL developer or BI developer cannot move to data engineering. It's just a matter of time. It may take a little bit of more time, nothing more than that. Okay, nothing more than that. So it's just a matter of time. Now let me remove these things from here. Okay, and let me tell you that now people start asking, okay, so from where should I start? So I suggest everyone, you should start from SQL and Python. Okay, SQL and Python, and then there are many Azure services that are relevant to data engineering. Okay, many Azure services that are relevant to data engineering that you need to learn. I've already created a video, okay, for complete roadmap. Okay, complete roadmap for Azure data engineering. If you go into my channel, you will be able to see it. Okay, I have already created a video on this. You can go and watch that video. Okay, so it's just these SQL developer and BI developer are mostly aware of this SQL. That's why it is easy for them. That's why I said that it is easy for them. But it's not like that if it is easy for them, it's not easy for these people. It is equivalently achievable by the people who are working in these profiles. Okay, it's just they may take little bit of more time to learn the things. Okay, I hope this video might have cleared many doubt that that is coming inside your mind. If you really like my video, please like, subscribe and share to my channel. Thank you so much. Take care.